KRMG Morning News. Let's spend a few minutes going in depth with Russell Mills.
KRMG goes in depth.
It is a question that has been, there are 300,000 Oklahomans who signed a petition on this state question.
802.
802, yep. that would basically put Medicaid in the state constitution. Now, explain that part of it, putting Medicaid in the state constitution.
Well, here's the bottom line. Ain't nobody happy with health care, right?
Right.
Nobody was happy before Obamacare or the ACA. Nobody was happy with the ACA. Nobody's happy now. And so this would basically enshrine Medicaid expansion in the state's constitution. And I could explain it, but I'd rather let Amber England explain it. She is the executive director for Yes on 802.
It's a poverty level. So what Medicaid expansion will do is say individuals making up to $17,000 a year and family three making $29,000 a year would qualify for Medicaid. And what that does, it allows people that can't afford insurance now but are working adults, particularly working in for usually small businesses that don't offer a health insurance plan, retirees that nearing retirement age that don't quite qualify for Medicare yet, they're not old enough for Medicare, but they make too much, those folks would be covered under this Medicaid expansion. What we know is it'll cover about 200,000 more Oklahomans today than are receiving Medicaid right now.
So the governor's plan, which is the president's plan, would be a block grant. The government would give us about $1 billion. Either way, it's going to be about $1 to $1.2 billion, somewhere around there, for health care. The block grant basically gives the state a lot more control. It gives the state the ability to add different co-pays or different upfront costs.
Or put restrictions like work requirements, things like that on it.
And the work requirements one is going to be a big one.
Yeah.
So it gives the state a lot more power to decide how the money gets spent.
Why do the supporters of the state question want to put it in the Constitution as opposed to just passing a law?
Because they feel like health care too long has been under the control of politicians and lobbyists and business owners. They think fundamentally that healthcare is a human right and that, basically it should be as universal as possible.
And why does Governor Stitt oppose putting it into the Constitution?
I think he feels like mandating it that way locks it into a box where we can't be flexible and adjust to the changing needs for healthcare. Also, the block grant program does set aside money for healthcare in rural areas, which is hugely important and a big problem in Oklahoma.
And this is a Trump administration block grant, right? And our governor, the first to sign on for it?
Yep, the Trump administration came up with this plan. It's not everything Republicans wanted, but it's, in their opinion, better than the ACA. And yes, Oklahoma would be the first state to sign up. In fact, Governor Stitt was the only governor actually there yesterday in Washington, D.C. for the announcement.
As far as the state question, they've gathered and verified the signatures.
So nearly 300,000. They needed 178,000. Yeah,
that's like
verified
double,
now.
That's like double the pot signatures, right?
Yes, way more than medical cannabis got. So one would imagine that the governor's going to face some political headwinds trying to get his plan and trying to stop 802. My question is going to be, and with this weird schedule, I haven't been able to ask him yet. My question is going to be, can we do both?
Can we? What do you?
I don't know. And I think maybe we could, because one is saying, these people need to be covered. And the other one's saying, well, here's some money that we could use to cover them. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I don't know. And I'm certainly no expert, but I'm going to ask that question. I think it's a great question.
And has 802 been scheduled for a vote?
No. And that's the interesting thing. He's got basically two dates that he could schedule this, right? Which, remember, he's opposed to 802.
Oh, yeah. We got a primary coming up and we got a general
schedule
election.
June during the primaries or November during the generals, to, take your pick either way.
Fascinating. Thank you, Russell, for filling us in. 6:43.